So we got to talk about what happened on a recent Frontier flight. That might be a case of quote unquote instant karma. Well, an unruly passenger was arrested and charged after he allegedly groped two flight attendants and got into a physical altercation with a third. TMZ got some more video where you can hear some of his rants. So take a listen to that. In response, flight attendants duct taped him to the seat and taped his mouth shut while other passengers can be heard laughing. Now, check out this other angle that shows him taped down. There he is calling for help after he was able to get the tape off his mouth. The passenger, Max Berry, has responded on Twitter saying, quote, "This will forever be the most dehumanizing experience in my entire life. Many people laughed and ridiculed me as I was mistreated by staff of a professional airline." He also denied groping anyone. In a statement, the airline confirmed the incident and said the flight attendants will be put on paid leave pending an investigation as is required, which is standard, though, per that airline. And then also, wait, Erica, chime in, because look at Erica's face. Put a camera on that.
I just don't understand these people.
It's disgusting.
Who do the dumbest stuff. And then nobody asked, no one was really sharing his name. Why would you come forward? Why would you come forward and co-sign? Yeah, this was me being a complete idiot. The privilege. First of all, the fact that he talked about his parents being so wealthy and they're worth $2 million. Okay, I'm not even putting, like, $2 million is a lot of money, okay? But you cannot be a grown man talking about the wealth of $2 million of your family and as if that somehow reflects on you. Like, this is so asinine on so many levels. And the fact that the flight attendants would actually be, they were suspended. They were suspended.
But that's
protocol. There should be air law.
Okay, and I agree with you. I think the airline nonsense has gone up high. The CNBC says 3,100 incidents happened up till June this year, and almost half a million was spent paying those fines. But this dude didn't deserve to be duct taped to the chair. That was out of line.
What else is he supposed to do?
They need to land the plane. This marshals his protocol.
Did you hear him?
So that's why these people are suspended. You can't duct tape a man.
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can. And he said this.
You cannot duct tape a grown man to the seat.
Let me ask you this. When he said, "Wait till you see what's coming for you." After 9/11, duct tape that passenger.
When you see what's coming to you, he means he's going to sue the airline. You duct tape him.
You don't know that. He could have rushed
the pilot. He has an argument though now. He has an argument in court. Is all I'm saying, that you duct taped him to the seat.
If you're one of those passengers on that flight, are you telling me that you would be standing up and advocating for a man being duct taped when he is putting everyone's life in jeopardy?
No, I would want him to be taken down in whatever way possible. So duct tape.
Well, they did.
But
they duct taped him.
I just think the duct tape wasn't the best choice.
I'm with Erica. I want to say before we wrap, of course it was wrong. It was abhorrent. He was arrested. He was charged. He has not been convicted yet, but he was charged. An investigation is taking place. But yeah, the duct taping part, that just seemed...
It seems necessary.
So now we got to sit on
There's
people.
Not
people
an entire
he can go to jail, but he don't need to be duct taped.
They were in the air.
Like, this is not a Bond movie.